Alrighty, folks, countdown's begun. For the next series, we have Mr. Curious going to be going up against J-Dong in ZVZ to determine who advances on to play against either Rain or somebody. Cure. I think it's Cure. Okay, so before we get into that game, just to remind you guys about our lovely raffle that we have going on for this awesome Heart of the Swarm t-shirt signed by people from the previous stop. I understand that these signatures may be upside down. They're not upside down. Oh, wow. I did that pretty well, actually. It's the top eight from WCS Europe Season 1. So go over to facebook.com/ESLTV. Like the page, as well as go down to the picture of me looking like a derp next to this thing. And then you just leave a comment. Anything you need to. It's all good. And then you have a chance to win that. We'll announce it at the end of the broadcast. But for now, let's get straight into game number one, ZVZ, between J-Dong and Curious. As we have Curious indeed spawning up to the top left-hand corner as our red Zerg. And then down to the bottom right, we have EG J-Dong, aka barcode line, 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 line. All right. So, how are you guys all doing? You doing good? You enjoying the games? I know I am. A lot, actually. The games have been great. I love casting the Korean qualifiers for Cologne. The only downside is the fact that you normally need to get up at like 6 a.m. if you want to do all the morning stuff and then come into the office and, you know, get everything prepared. But it's so worth it. So worth it. Because the level of games that you get to cast, it's basically like championship level games, like every series. So a lot of fun to be here casting these. All right, so Frost is our first map. Surprise, surprise. Frost is the first map in every single one of these map pools that people are electing to go for. And it's going to be Hatchery first for the pair of them. Now, when it comes to Curious's previous chances, in terms of how he's played in Intel Extreme Masters in the past. What we've seen from him is he does phenomenally in qualifiers, obliterates all the Terrans, obliterates all the Protosses, and then just advances on. But one of his main roads through the Intel Extreme Masters was cut short by Zerg versus Zerg. We saw that, unfortunately for him, he did fall to life during the Intel Extreme Masters New York, during like a semi-final or something like that. And that's been really it for Curious. I haven't really seen too much of his ZVZ. Meanwhile, we have J-Dong on the other end of the spectrum, who built an entire legend on ZVZ for a long time, albeit most of during Brood War. To the point where it was dubbed JVZ, but now here in Heart of the Swarm in StarCraft 2, he's actually still pretty good at it still. Some of the core fundamentals of, you know, decision making and things like that do still apply, and J-Dong just transitions very, very nicely. So we'll see if Curious can stand toe to toe with J-Dong. As for now, both players know where they've spawned because of Overlords crossing one another down to the bottom left. They know it's cross positions, despite not spotting one another. And also all the Overlords spotted the other two corners anyway. So for now, we're going to see what Curious has got up his sleeves. As J-Dong with his little frilled Zerglings looks to move out, whilst unfortunately for Curious, he doesn't have the little frill. Not sure why. But anyway, I guess he just opts not to use it. Curious is actually going to throw down a Spinecrawler, feeling a little bit more apprehensive about his position in this game. J-Dong, he's getting speed, and he's also grabbing himself extra gas. So we could see some J-Dong aggression. Meanwhile, Curious, he's getting the Spinecrawler basically because he didn't have any gases taken to begin with. He was playing very, very mineral focused, and you have to be careful about getting hit by something super aggressive from that point onwards. Now, interestingly enough, he can actually get this, unless he believes that there's going to be more links than just these two, and actually pulls on back, anticipating that maybe there was more link production than just those initial two. So this Overlord could have been killed, but Curious decides not to. Meanwhile, back at home for Jadon, he's grabbing himself that double evolution chamber, and he's even grabbing himself a quick sneaky third base, something which will be spotted instantaneously by Curious. So the fundamental difference here between the two is that, unfortunately for Curious, it's very difficult for him to even punish that third base at the timing that his opponent's taken it. He didn't have gases earlier on. He doesn't have any speed anywhere near production. It's going to finish up in like 100 seconds at the same time which the hatchery basically does. So technically, he could time out his flurry of aggression to arrive just as speed's about to finish, but I mean, it's by the by. You know, Jadon would always have the creep connecting those bases. He would have the queens in position to defend as well. Maybe even transfuses on the hatchery if he saves up a little bit of energy from them. And he's going to have plus one, one already well underway. And in Curious's position, who is looking to probably go for the Roach incorporation into this, that has been spotted with double evolution chambers, then against the 1-1 here, he's not going to have any melee, and he's not going to have Carapace in time for when the 1-1 is done here for Jadon. So Curious has to be very, very careful about this move out. Of course, this big, big swell of Zerglings is what we were alluding to earlier, but it just gets completely shut down. I mean, if I was anticipating something like that after what both players had seen here in DBZ, so was Jadon. Jadon was well on point with dealing with that. And now his third hatchery is well and truly underway in comparison to Curious's, who is having a little bit of a harder time catching up. Now, the one good thing for Curious here is that if by chance... Hold the phone. If by chance... he's able to get into a good, like, condensed pocket of positioning here with his roaches, then they're not going to really die off to 1-1 lings with a good surround. Oh, sorry, with the roaches balled up properly. However, these lings are going to continue to try and press the issue. 1-1 is now finished. Jadon's going to transition into roaches with plus one himself. So this is the one big key point here that Curious can try and play on. The fact that his ranged weapons will be much, much quicker than than Jadon's. So, cleans up a few of those lings. Again, 1-1 for melee and Carapace makes a big difference against 0-0 on those lings. And unit counts is 54 workers to 57, actually in favor of Curious. But his income has been lacking behind a little bit because his third base has not been up and running. So he does have to take that into account. So things are going to like normalize out a little bit here, especially if we see a delay on the plus two weapons taken by Curious. If this plus one weapons is allowed to catch up a little bit, then we will certainly see the catch up here from Jadon. And also, he still has quite a few lings on the field. The lings for lings, traded so nicely for Jadon that he still has the majority of his alive. And that's always going to be a big threat to Curious, to the point where it's very difficult for him to ever move out across the map. Those lings are always going to threaten on the top position here and then try and go for the run by if they see anything move out. Because this Overseer, it's keeping a keen eye on what is going on in this particular area. That's what those lings are going to do. And, well, there was a slight delay on this plus two weapons upgrade. So Curious is giving Jadon the opportunity to get back in if he starts his plus two right as this finishes. His upgrades will work out quite nicely for him. Meanwhile, it's 31 roaches to about 31 roaches, so very, very close in that regard. Just added another two there. And actually, Tunneling Claws comes out for Curious. So Curious is probably going to try and go for some multitude of aggression in terms of sending a few roaches here and there to bases, unburrowing them in mineral lines, and trying to kill off some drones. Thankfully for these roaches, they are a little bit more quick underground. But also we have Burrow coming out for Jadon. So very, very, very similar styles here. Whilst we have the Infestation Pit also going down for Curious, just to keep him going. Keep him transitioning on against an opponent that's probably making a very, very similar style as well. which he doesn't fully know yet. But now, he sees this with the Overlord. It's very soon the time of the Lings to move in. He's having a little bit of a look around. And if those roaches move any further down south, the Lings shall attack. But meanwhile, there's plenty of roaches here for Jadong. 56 roaches against 49. And he did see it strand creep for just a second there. The Lings are going to go, but the roaches are already coming back. So Curious is reading this well, but he's still very much far out of position. The Lings separate up in all sorts of directions here to try and get something done and actually burrow during all of this. A smart move, realizing that they wouldn't end up dying off as well. Oh, he barely doesn't get that queen. He should get that. Curious knows that these have burrowed. Meanwhile, movement of roaches in the middle. Now, Jadong, if he'd looked at those roaches properly, he will have noticed that they do have tunneling claws. These Zerglings could just turn around and kill off that queen. But they're just on hold position here, trying to deny some drones from getting some mining. Get the queen, get the queen, get the queen. This Ling, go get the queen. Go. But aside from that, we now have Jadong adding on his own infestation pit as well. Pathogen Glands is on the way for Curious, but the big engagement does occur. And, well, kind of difficult to tell who's going to win out on this one. The plus two armor is finished already for Curious in comparison to Jadong's. But Jadong does have the better concave for just a little bit there. A few of these roaches are dancing around at the back, and Curious has been forced to fall back. Jadong did a very, very clever thing there of moving back beyond this particular choke. And now does end up burrowing, is going to heal himself up a little bit. With no presence of an Overseer there, this is a very, very clever move. It also allows his roaches reinforcing to get into the fight. And all of his roaches are firing now, and they also healed up quite a lot. Unit counts, 51 roaches to 46, but infestors have now popped for Curious. Not the best of fungals, but he's going to look for some more. You want some more, mate? And, well, he's going to have to just chill out for now. So he realizes, Jadong realizes that he can't really compete too easily with his opponent's pathogen glands and infestors. So he'll sit around back at home for now and get his going as well. Whilst we have also Jadong being able to spot this base up to the north. So he knows that his fourth base is going to pay for itself quite quickly. And, ooh, sneaky, sneaky. But also sneaky, sneaky. I don't think those actually saw one another. But this is going to be good because Jadong, Curious is going to draw his opponent away. Now, the thing is, though, is that if Jadong sees that roach army and sees that it's not that big, it's not that big. Where are your other roaches? Look at this. So instantly turns on around. Although, that being said, he did have vision of it of the Overlords. Meanwhile, we have the roaches cancelling the fourth base up to the north. Very good move here by Jadong. Landing the fungals just to seal these roaches in, making sure that they will die. And we start another fourth base up here. Meanwhile, roaches trying to do some damage and getting a few workers. Nine have already died. There's still that one Ling. I don't think he's going to do too much, but there is still that one Ling. The roaches back here, not doing too badly. Hey, still another Ling there. How did he get there? But 12 workers gone down so far. All right, so it's 54 to 57. It's just roach, 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 and infestors. And, well, not much is going on right now, to be honest with you. Ooh, I don't think, unless he's going to get both upgrades at the same time, there are builds, the ZVP builds, that you do get upgrades at the same time. Is he going to get upgrades at the same time? If so, this is cool. I mean, he's got a bit of a bank. He's got a fourth base over his opponent that is mining gas compared to this. So he could, in theory, make this work. Yeah, Jadong. Sick. Okay, so that's cool. That's cool. I like the advantages that he's trying to take from here. Because, I mean, his economy is always stronger right now. He's even killed off a lot of drones at his opponent's bases as well. So why not do this? Why not get those upgrades flourishing? It's not the most massive of investments, and it does speed up your composition quite a lot. And I don't mean just literally with the Hydralisks being sped up. I mean, you know, it certainly makes it more potent. All right, well, there's roaches down to this bottom left. well set up spine crawlers here for Jadong to be able to push those away. And we're about to have muscular augments finish for both of these players. But as mentioned before, Curious did already get his range as well. So that was that tactic that we saw from that double Hydralisk play, Hydralisk Den play, in the end only just kind of catches up with the position that Curious was in. But again, he could afford it. Curious. I actually didn't notice that he got a Hive morphed in. So this is something that Jadong wasn't quite expecting this quickly. Of course, he does have his Hive going down behind this. But that 3-3 has a lot of momentum over what we're seeing from Jadong right now. So this 3-3 could be a deal breaker here for Jadong if Curious is able to take an engagement at the proper time. Also, both players grabbing themselves a Spire. I think they normally go into the Broodlords from this point on. In terms of Roaches and Hydras, and then Infestors and blah 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 and Broodlords. So if we get to a Broodlord versus Broodlord army, I'm a sad panda because it gets a bit strange. I recall the GSL finals that we were watching when we were at the Intel Extreme Masters World Championship, and it was on at the same time. And that first game between Solki and... I can't remember. Solki and Symbol, maybe? Anyway, whatever. Whatever the case, some nice Fungals actually hit a big, big clump of Hydralisks up to the top right-hand corner. That's going to negate a lot of the damage from Curious very, very quickly, even popping some of those during all of that. Meanwhile, the Roach is still holding on a little bit strong, but Curious's Hydras will be able to power on through. He had a great concave during all of that. He grabbed some of the Infestors on the retreat out as well. Oh, and a lovely little Fungal growth to catch the remaining. Of them. All right, so another base goes up for Curious, up to the north. His fourth base is well and truly underway, but as is Jadong's, it has been for quite a while, and he's going to grab himself his own fifth base. Curious now swinging around to the right-hand side. We have that Greater Spire morphing in for Curious. He's one step ahead at every given time. But this is a really nice concave here for Jadong. If he can trade off a lot of his opponent's units, this could be the window that he needs. If he kills off a lot here, then it's going to make this 3-3 window a little less strong for Curious, because he just won't have any army to actually make it work. But at the same time, it's kind of just going blow for blow. So Curious still does all right with this. And he's got Roaches harassing over on this right-hand side. Army supply is 120 to 110. And now 3-3 is completed. This is Curious's opportunity to really seize this game by the balls if he actually wants to push across. 3-3, of course, on the way for Jadong. But he's going to have to resort to sitting around with his Roaches and Hydras and chilling for a little bit. Also, the Greater Spire finishing up. Whilst Curious is putting all of this pressure, he's going to secure that base up to the top right. Arguably, he wants those gas geysers so that he can get those Broodlord numbers flowing. He's got seven more Sakuruptors to bring out the power. Jadong has to be careful about this army positioning. If he gets sandwiched in between these Roaches and some other units, he could be in a bit of a bad spot. Of course, he does have these... excuse me. He does have these Overlords actually spotting that, though. And the 3-3 is quickly looming here for Jadong as well. But as I said, he could get sandwiched. He has to be careful. Has to retreat out of here. Those Hydralisks aren't as fast as those Roaches. As they try and chase everything down... Curious knows he's in a good spot. He sees the 3-3 against the 2-2. He's going to go for the engagement. So is Jadong. That could be a fatal mistake for Jadong, as all of these Roaches are going to be able to trade significantly better over Jadong's. And now Broodlords are morphing in the sky above him. Jadong is against the ropes. Despite his 3-3 finishing up, these Roaches chase him all the way back to those reinforcements. And Jadong does not have his Greater Spire morphed in. Oh, and he loses so many of these units on the right-hand side that are forced to fight. Otherwise, he would lose one of these essential mining bases. Meanwhile, a base did end up going down to some Roaches over here, and the Roaches on this left-hand side are putting on the pressure. But this is getting very, very close. Curious doing pretty well with the Roaches at the front. 3-3 now finished up for Jadong, but now the Air Armada looms as they move into attack formation and really start to seize all of Jadong's land on his side of the map. The Roach is trying to make something happen over at the fourth base, but realistically, what can he do when all of his reinforcements are cut off by the Roaches? The Broodlords start to rain down terror from the skies, and Curious really did seize this game by the balls, I gotta say. This is going to be difficult for Jadong to recover against. Of course, he's actually killing off quite a bit of a worker count, but the Roaches can just separate themselves absolutely everywhere. Jadong has very, very little in terms of production right now. And I'm pretty sure he lost his Roach Warren, so can't make any more Roaches. It's just going to be Hydralisks from there on out for Jadong. Or even Corruptus to try and bring these Broodlords down, which is actually isn't too bad an idea. But Curious realizes that he lost a lot of his Hydra numbers and has to replenish those to be able to try and keep those Broodlords alive. Night Transfuse is here by Jadong to keep, by Curious to keep as many of them alive as possible. But as I say, with his base now under siege and the Roaches going to town on the other locations, Jadong's hopes are all but fizzled out here in game number one. As you can see, doing all right for himself. Doing all right. Well, Jadong's trying to hold on. But again, it's more fantasy-esque GG timing, as all his hatcheries are going to end up dying. And he doesn't have a single clue about this base up the top right. He could just finish that off and reveal everything. But it doesn't matter. Either way. The Corruptors are trying to look for Broodlords desperately. And I think actually they found them, but this is just a little bit too scared of the Fungals as well as a few Hydras that do chill out there. I think Jadong thinks this game is a little bit closer than it actually is. I was curious with that base up to the top right is doing not too badly for himself. And, well, with these Corruptors Fungled, that means all hopes of him killing off these Broodlords are all but shattered. Not doing too bad with the Roaches. Drones even fighting here for Jadong. And trying to get what they can done. But very soon, once he sends like a Roach to every single base, where is he going? Okay, he's just rallying around and searching for this. As soon as he finds this, then it shall be done here for Jadong. The drones valiantly trying to kill off buildings where they can. But surely, he has to realize also that once this hive dies and he's not being revealed, then, ooh, these infestors, where are you going, Curious? Oh, well, there you go, GG, game number one goes to Curious. A little bit of a prolonged ending there to game number one, but regardless, Curious is able to be victorious. So now we wait for game number two here between Jadong and Curious. Let's see if we have any updates in our bracket. Rain was able to advance on versus Cure. And we can actually show you the brackets, guys, on stream and see and show exactly all the routes of these players that have come along. So now we are left with our final four players, which if I just scroll in a little bit, is a pretty good line of players. We have Curious and Jadong currently playing one another for the chance to play against Rain, for the chance to play against SOS. So four absolute top dogs of StarCraft II duking it out for the final spot of the Intel Extreme Masters Cologne. And I believe now I need to also check if we have another invite. Yes, we do. Yeonsu will be our map. Probably a little bit of a quicker game here on Yeonsu compared to what we see on Frost. Just in general, a lot of pros are really, really liking Frost because it does give them that opportunity to swing straight into that big, big macro game. But Yeonsu is a bit more of an aggressive map, a bit more of a smaller map. So maybe we'll see some quirkiness out of these guys. Maybe we'll see some Baneling Wars earlier on as we now get loaded up and good to go. So a big thanks for joining me here, guys, on the stream. I really do appreciate it here at ESL TV. And it's a pleasure to be bringing these games to you. The Korean qualifiers for the Intel Extreme Masters are always phenomenal and really good games to cast. So it's all good. All right, let's jump into game number one as we have spawning down to the bottom left-hand corner. Currently, game number two even, sorry, I should say. That is correct. Spawning down to the bottom left-hand corner as our red Zerg. He is Startel Curious. And up to the top right. Needs to bring it back. He needs to win this game or he is eliminated. He is EG Jadong. Okie dokies. Curious. I'm looking at Curious. And he is going to early pool. As is Jadong. why am I not surprised? Exactly the same builds. It's Yeonsu, man. I mean, what are you going to do? It's Yeonsu. All right. So this is going to be interesting. Basically, what's going to happen here is Lings are going to run by one another, and they'll be like, wait a minute. Oh, this is going to be fun. Okie dokies. So, Overlords in production. And there's not really a whole lot to say at this point, other than we just have to wait for the Lings to come along. Technically, Curious did an extractor trick a little bit quicker than Jadong there. And actually, now that I look at it, Curious? There was something different about Curious's build just then. He had his Overlord finishing a lot slower than his opponent. But anyway, it doesn't matter. Six Lings are in production for Curious, as well as a Queen, a little bit faster than Jadong, so seemingly he wants to transition out of this a bit easier. But it's just Lings, Lings, Lings at this point. All right. Where are they going to meet? Are they going to meet? Oh, God. I think they're just both going to... Well, this is funny. Oh, okay. Oh, he changed his path to try and greet them. Because they did run past that Overlord. Oh, as did thingies. So, all right. Micro, 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 micro. Oh, you find yourself closer to my reinforcing Lings. I'm just going to watch, guys. I mean, I'm not commentating on six Lings fighting Slings. I'm just going to shout micro, 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 micro. And I'll be doing the same job. Actually, no, this is good for Jadong. His micro's been pretty good. Curious is trying to wiggle on around it, and it's not paid off for him. All right. GG, Jadong wins. Okay. So, during all of that, he lost one extra Zergling. Ooh, he could have evened up the odds there by getting that extra Zergling. Close calls. All right, now, Curious has actually been mining gas this whole time, whereas Jadong has not. So Jadong, both players were looking to drone behind that anyway, and this is probably going to normalize out. But what we could see Curious do is just bank up a ton of Zerglings after throwing down the hatchery, most importantly, I would say. Because if you do not throw down the hatchery, this Overlord's always keeping a good eye on it, and you're just like, that's too obvious. So he could follow this up with full Ling production and then just try and break his opponent. But it feels to me like Jadong has some kind of star sense and does throw down the spine in his base. Jadong's preparing for this, man. Jadong is preparing for this. And this Ling getting in really gives him a good tip off. There's so many Zerglings in production. Those two Zerglings actually weren't spotted just then, but now they are, obviously. Bainly Nest goes down as well. Jadong, after seeing the gas coming in and after seeing the spawning pool whirring away, he has to know that something is going on, especially with the timing of this expansion, which was a little bit later than his, but he has to make sure that his defenses are sturdy and will hold. He was actually getting a few more drones there, and it's kind of suspect as to whether or not he can make those work out. The thing is that if he gets like a 3 or 4 drone lead during all of this, then the Queens as a defensive posture will compensate for the fact that he doesn't have as many Lings, but now speed has finished. Baneling Nest is also about to finish as well. Can't quite easily transition that Spine Crawler down to the low ground, but now he could. There's a little window of opportunity here for him to get that on the low ground, and he's going to go for it. Two Banelings now morph in. Ideally, Curious doesn't really want to go too quickly before those Banelings are here, otherwise he's going to have a hard time. But now he sees the Spine Crawler. Now he knows that he has a bit of a timer above his head, as those Banelings are going to go straight for this when they want to. Morphing in a few more. But Jadong, I think he's going to be okay against this. Tries to throw down Evolution Chamber as well as Roach Warren. That will seal this off a little bit further. It cancels the Roach Warren. And those 5 Banelings, can they get much of anything done? The Spinecrawler as well as that Queen really need to focus down on those. All of those Banelings are really kind of caught up in between all of this. And the Spinecrawler will end up falling. Curious decides to pull on back, though. He just does not have the firepower. He doesn't have the Lings. He's making 18 more, but Jadong seems to have had a good read on what was going on previously, and this is walled off. The Lings that can only go around the hatchery here to really make something happen. Still more Lings on the way. Behind this, he's morphing in his lair. He realizes that his opponent's trying to go up to a Roach Warren, and he fully completes that wall off. That's going to be very, very hard now for him to break in through. And oh, good queen positioning. Really good retreat out there. The spine crawler needs to burrow. It's going to take a little while though. 12 seconds in game. Just really try and keep this defense alive, but a nice transfuse as well. The drones even come off the line, pushing this back. Jadong, with good crisis management, hasn't lost a single worker despite utilizing them in that battle. Plus one weapons. Now well underway here. Even cheekily poking out and getting a little Zergling for his troubles. But the Zerglings and Queens do hold on for him. All right, so it's 1-1 upgrades with Roaches coming out here for Jadong, whilst Curious has very little to go on. Yes, he did get his lair, and he is grabbing himself a Spire, but he only has 32 workers compared to 38. Not the biggest of deficits. But now Jadong's looking to put on the hurt himself. And with these Lings, he forces out his opponent to make a lot of Lings, maybe even some Banelings. And behind that, he can drone as well. So he's going to extend that lead a little bit further. Ooh, Duke and Jive, Duke and Jive. Careful. I mean, these Lings are almost guaranteed to die because they are sealed in this base so heavily. So maybe if he could have got a drone or two focused down, that would have been nice. But they managed to get out, realizing that the Banelings have moved out into the middle of the map with these Overlords. So, plus one weapons for Roaches is already done. If I can't help but feel if Jadong actually just went very, very aggressive with a 1-1 timing, then that could work out. But actually, the Lings get a good surround on these Queens, but they do have too much energy for transfuses. Curious realizes that and moves back out. There was never really a total guarantee of him being able to kill off any of these. They still have energy for transfuses. Not sure what he's doing. But now a Nidus Worm for Jadong goes down. He knows there's a Spire there, of course. So he needs to get across the other side of the map very, very quickly. He does have five Queens. The thing is that any transfuses that those Zerglings could have soaked out from those Queens then makes this Nidus Worm Roach Queen play a little bit worse. Because obviously then you don't have enough transfuses to keep the Queens alive whilst they're trying to fend off the Mutalisks, if you actually want to do this. Where is he going to throw the Nidus Worm is the big question. There it is. Alright. So, yes, Mutalisks are about to pop, but there's nothing but Queens in production, as well as the Roaches here, to go along with these Roaches. And actually, he's bringing back the Roaches that were in the middle of the map to that Nidus Worm. So, clear reconstitution finished up in 9 seconds anyway. But now, Curious is going to have a whole lot of trouble fending this off. Another Nidus Worm goes down just in case the Mutalisks try and swing on around the left-hand side here to pick off that one. Very, very smart move here by Jadong to add multiple routes to this. But this is a lot of aggression that we're seeing from Jadong. A lot of army supplies, 70 to 44. And the Queens do get engaged upon, but the transfuses will keep them alive for now. He needs to bring every Queen that he can with him. But it's also important to note that the Queen with the most energy, if Jiris is doing this correctly, he will try and bring down the ones with the most energy to fend this off. But he's actually just focusing down on the one at the very front there. That's not the most wise of decisions. I mean, he doesn't really have too much of an option, but at the same time, the ones at the back with the energy gonna hold on. Jadong takes the game 1-1 apiece. And that means we're gonna go into a game 3 in just a second, guys, here for Zerg versus Zerg. So I really do like Zerg versus Zerg when it gets to those late game situations like we saw in game number 1, and then when it gets to these more interesting situations in game number 2, where both players are choosing different tech routes and trying to make that work. I say different tech routes, and both of them 9 pulled early on, oh well. So, game number 3, being invited into Polar Night is our map. Do we see more earlier spawning pools? We could do. I mean, after both of them did it in that game and they're like, again. Why not even try it this game and see how it goes? You wouldn't anticipate it from 2 times in a row after you've both done it that time, but... All right, so I think everyone's here. Good luck, good luck. Curious is saying, caster. What's, I don't know what SSSSS means for Koreans. Good to go by me. Okay, so, talking to him as if like, yeah. So, game number three will be Polar Knight. This will decide who goes on to play against Rain. And then from that point on, the winner of Rain or Curious or Jadong will play against SOS for that final spot. So after this game, we're guaranteed at least two more series today. What time is it? The time is... Oh, okay, we're at 1:30. Not too bad, actually. Been casting some good old StarCraft since 9 o'clock, and I'm actually happy to get the solo casting practice in because it makes my voice more resilient. Going through these like endurance casts, but I haven't done that much solo casting for quite a while, so I'm trying to get back into the swing of things and enjoying it a lot. If you'd like to support me, guys, go and follow me at Kyle Aris on Twitter, K-A-E-L-A-R-I-S. And for now, we're going to jump into game number three here for the Intel Extreme Masters Cologne Qualifiers. It's going to determine who advances on to play Rain. That's going to be a good series. We're guaranteed another PVZ. So we do have Curious spawning down to the south. And up to the north, we have Jadong. Okay, are we going to see any pools is the question. Jadong already goes up to 10 drones. And Curious, yay! See, I told you, man.
I told you.
He loves doing it. He loves it. He absolutely loves it. So, this could work out all right for him, depending on what Jadong is going to throw down. We'll see what he wants to do. And very, very curious to see how Jadong is going to play against this. Does he go hatchery first, or does he go spawning pool first? Well, that spawning pool is on the way. I'm seeing something in the distance on my producer's PC that makes me think I'm going to have to take a picture very soon. Yep. Damn it. All right. And for now, we have pool first here for Jadong. So he should be able to eventually sneak out some lings just as these arrive. It's going to take quite a while for these lings to head on over. But at the same time, he may have to cancel his natural to get the minerals necessary to have those lings out and around at the right time. The Overlord will see those lings on the way. So now we'll see what Jadong wants to do in terms of a response. Of course, with that much foresight from the Overlord spotting it, and with the pool going down at this particular timing, he can save up. Like, he doesn't have to commit all this lava. He didn't commit that lava to drones, you know, just in a normal fashion. So he saves the lava, he gets the lings producing, as well as a queen. So now, technically, he will have some Zerglings available to him to deal with this without having to cancel necessarily. But if he doesn't control this properly, he brings down a few drones as well. A wise move here from Jadong. Wise, but will it be the right one? As he has to control this properly against these Zerglings, who are doing a good job in terms of dealing with this hatchery. And he's going to end up going for the engagement pretty soon. That's quite a lot of lings that we're seeing out here for Curious. He has 10 with 2 more rendezvousing. And looks like he's being forced into a bit of an odd spot here against this. So that hatchery is still very low. Not too many losses. Only one unit gone down here. But that queen coming down certainly makes this a little bit easier for Jadong to hold on against. And this has been a really impressive defense by Jadong. Just straight down the line. Very, very strong. Seven units killed to 2. He's killed 7 Zerglings. He lost 2. He has a hatchery up and running. Curious does not. Curious behind this now has to go for some kind of speed all in, I imagine. Whilst Jadong, all he has to do is identify that, build a wall off, build a spine crawler, and he is looking good to advance on. The Zerglings in production. These are going to have to hold on against the Zerglings that we're seeing for Jadong, but once again, he still has full confirmation that his opponent does not have a hatchery. Still a load of Zerglings in production. He sees them even hatching now. They surround, kill off the queen. That's actually a big deal, because on one base here, without the lava injects, if you have a saturated mineral line, you need the lava injects to be able to spend all the money on Zerglings. So that was a smart move by Jadong there. And I think that one action alone may have just forced Curious to grab this expansion instead of going for some huge all-in play. Of course, also those Lings breaching up into the main and seeing only Zerglings in production also tip him off to that kind of play. But now the Zerglings are pushing across the map here for Curious. There's already a relatively strong wall off here, but actually there's a huge hole on the right-hand side, so that wasn't the best of wall-offs, and those Zerglings could quite easily run on into the main base. There is not a queen there, as it was brought down from the natural. Also, these bases aren't connected with creep either, so the queens are going to have a little bit of a hard time really getting to that spot. Jadong tries to drone drill in that crevice in between the minerals to buy some time for these queens to get back there. Still has not lost a drone during this aggression. Unit counts, 32 drones to 20. Looking to keep it alive, but he's actually gonna try and focus down the hatchery. Will he be able to get it in time? The two spine crawlers as well as drones and the transfuses keep it alive. Oh, Curious does not make it work. Whew. Curious is in such a bad spot in this game now. Having sacrificed all of those Lings to try and get a hatchery. Oh, he got a drone. He got one drone. But now with 36 drones against 26, and only just now this expansion finishing, now morphing into a layer. It's desperate times here for Curious. It really is. More Lings poking on out. But Jadong from here could quite happily do exactly the same tactic that he did in the previous game and feel comfortable. But it looks as if he's gonna go for some kind of Mutalisk play. I mean, he's got double evolution chambers, and he's getting, okay, so I guess 1-1 with Gleary Constitution is the only answer to that. I was expecting the upgrades to start a little bit quicker, but he wasn't as committed to his gas as he was to just holding that off and surviving, which he did in spades. It's 45 workers to 30. Curious is about to have his layer finish up, and he's gonna go for Spire. There's really no other option here for Curious. But other than that, it's just drone to the third base, chilling on out, and then all is good from here on. Jadong looking good in this matchup. Very good. There goes Gleary Constitution. Wouldn't be surprised if we saw a Nidus Worm as well. But at the same time, Jadong has not identified that this is a Spire play, and as such has not started queen production. So roaches and queens with a Nidus Worm. Ah, okay, there's another one. Wait, he's already got three. If he starts another one on the base, then yeah, that could be good. I mean, he sees an Overseer, so he knows his opponent has a layer. Oh, he sees it anyway with the Changeling. Oh, the Changeling. Oh, he spots the Spire. All right, okay, so he can just start full queen production. It may be it's a little bit later than it was last game though. It really is a little bit later. So I feel that Jadong might have to play this out further with that third base. And he's actually adding on the infestation pit. Yeah, so because it is a little later that he spotted that compared to game number two, the Nidus Worm play that we saw there is just deterred from completely in this game. But there's still a lot of roaches. Those roaches are going to pile across the map towards that third base and buy him a good chunk of time, while some head over to the fourth, third himself, so these Lings aren't going to be too pesky. And now even a Spinecrawler has to be thrown up here for Curious. They got one queen in the end of those Zerglings, but did not get a second. For all of those Zerglings, not really the best of trades. And also, this third base is going to be forced to cancel. So once again, a really tight bind here for Curious, as roaches, not only from that third, but also from his third, now trying to swing in, go straight past that spine crawler, and look to try and find some damage here in the main. All of this, once again, as I said before, bind time to set himself up with pathogen glands, set himself up with spore crawlers. Once those mutalisks have finished cleaning up the mess that these roaches have left, the mutalisks go over there, prance around a bit in circles and then realize that there's too many spore crawlers for him to contend with. So, Evolution Chamber goes down here for Curious. I think Curious realizes now with these two Evolution Chambers that he can't really continue on with the Mutalisks after having them bought Titan. But in essence, now, because we see the game flow as it is and how things have gone on, technically the Mutalisks can buy time here for Curious. They grab a queen. Will they grab another? Yes, they do. But this buys time for him to now get his upgrades going on his roaches or lings or whatever he wants to do. It's going to be the roaches, of course, with that roach one going down. And it does have that third base on the way as well. But the Mutalisks will rule the map for a little while here. And Jadong is amassing three queens per cycle. So, and there's no like real focus on creep spread, actually. So I think that we may end up seeing Nidus again from him to really put on the hurt against his opponent. All of these queens, they're great for the defensive position, but without creep spread, then you're not going to get over there anytime soon and really put on the pressure. Of course, also the Infestors can zone them out if he wants to go for the assault with just roaches and Infestors. But I like the idea of bringing the queens along with for the ride. It's a lot of fun. It is. How many does he have right now? Yes, 8 in total. So the Infestation Pit for Curious is on the way, as is 1-1. But the upgrades are just leaps and bounds ahead for Jadong right now, as we have a small skirmish in the middle of the map. He starts his 2-2. And there's going to be a Hydralisk Den. Okay, so the options were amass all those queens, and then just make a Roach Warren. Sorry, make a Nidus Worm, go across with your roaches and Infestors, and try and kill. Or the second option was use all of those queens as really, really good support for when you're able to land these fungals defensively. And then just buy time for your Hydralisk Den to come out. And look at the chain fungling on those. Very, very nicely done. Catches quite a few of them. He did lose one or two Infestors for the trouble of that. But any Mutalisks that he can kill here really do alleviate the pressure that is being put on right now. So Overseer is going to head on in, sees no research on that spire, so is very content to know that it also needs to see the Infestation Pit as well. He's going to kill the spawning pool. Not the biggest of deals at this point now that that Jadong has so much tech available to him. As we have roaches now. I mean, Jadong's army is 92 army supply against 70. And it is just, I would say, more valuable in general in terms of how effective it's going to be when the battle actually comes. A lot of energy for the queens. He's deciding to just slowly trundle those across the map as opposed to using something like creep spread, which technically would detract from the energy that these queens do have, or a Nidus Worm, which could be a little bit scary in itself, but these Mutalisks, they are really playing a dangerous game. Unfortunately, he doesn't even get a single Infestor during that. And now we have Jadong maxed out with queen support at his army up front. Now, this is going to be a difficult hold here for Curious. Very difficult. He doesn't have as much energy on his Infestors. He doesn't have the ability to transfuse too much, at least. And with the reinforcing roaches here from Jadong, he's going to end up going for it. Infested Terrans are the choice here as he tries to push on forwards. A few of those Hydralisks at the back that were pinned down by Fungal Growth don't really do too much. Not too bad a Fungal Growth through the middle of this army, but as long as he's able to land the transfusers on these, he should be able to keep this going. The roaches are trying to penetrate through, but you've got to remember that there is 2-2 finish for these, and not only does it benefit the roaches and Hydralisks, but it also benefits the Infested Terrans when they were trying to pop, as well as these queens, as they continuously press the issue here, reinforcing with 27 roaches as opposed to only the 20 for Curious. Technically, yes, his reinforce point is shorter, but one of the hatcheries, the macro hatchery, ends up falling, and there's not that many queen transfusers left here. As long as he can reinforce with the extra roaches, he should be okay to continually make this happen. The thing is, he's trading blow for blow. It's going really, really nicely for Jadong. And the Remax should be able to push on through. And here we go, Jadong just really pressing the issue now. Curious has all but spent up here. There you go, GG. Jadong advances on. We are next going to see a Jadong versus Rain, and the winner of that will go on to play SOS. So guys, I'm going to take a quick break because my throat's bleh, but for now, I shall see you in a bit. The Intel Extreme Masters Clone Qualifiers, don't go anywhere.